Hey guys, Mark here. I hope you're all doing well. I got a few requests asking me to show you how to make a golf ball paracord key fob. So in this tutorial, we're going to make one that is fairly simple to make and still looks very appealing. If we move on to the supplies that you're going to need two cords, each about 10 feet long. You're also going to need a golf ball, a lacing needle. Optionally, you can use a rope thimble inside your loop. And finally, you're going to need a mandrel that's a bit bigger than your golf ball. So with these supplies ready, we can begin our project. And the first step is going to be setting up a type 1 pineapple knot tied out of a 9-part 8-byte Turk's head. So with this said, let's get into the first step. We're going to start by tying a 9-part 8-byte Turk's head. So take your working end, and we're going to start by making a wrap around our mandrel, going over the standing end, then coming around and going over again. We're going to continue with an under over. Then we're going to come around and we're going to lay the tracks, basically following our standing end, going under over. This creates two cords that we're going to then split. We're now going to enter our knot at the front, going over, under, over. We're now going to come around and split the two cords we just set up. So we have two parallel cords here, and we're going to split them by going over, under, over. And we're going to split two cords at the front now, going under, then over, under, over. We come again to the standing end, and we're going to again lay the tracks, basically following our standing end. Then at the front, we're going to go over, under. Over, under, and over. And this has again laid tracks for a new sequence where we split our cords. So we have two parallel cords again, and we're going to split them by going over, under, over, under, and finally over at the top. We're then going to split the next two parallel cords, starting with an under, then over, under, and over, under, over. We now have one more expansion to do, so we're again going to double our standing end. So follow your standing end to the top of the knot. Then enter the knot with an over, then under, over, under, and then over, under, over. And with this, we have laid another set of tracks which we need to split. So now we're going to go opposite to the cords we're splitting. So over, under, over, under, then over, under, over. Now we're going to split this pair. So we're going to start with an under. Then go over under. Over under. Over under and over. And with this we have tied a 9-part 8-byte Turk's head, which is going to be the base knot for our interweave. We now place our working end next to the standing end. I'm now going to work in some slack into the knot so it will be easier to work with. I have spread apart my knot a bit and worked in some slack, and I have placed another cord onto the left side of the standing end, and we're going to start our interweave with an under 2. Then go over under. Over under. And finally over under. Since this is a pineapple interweave, we're not going to exit our knot at the bottom or top, and we always end our sequence with an under. We start with an under as well, going under over, under over, under over, and under. We're going to start our sequence with an under again. Then go over under. Over under. And over under. The next sequence is going to be a bit different, and we're going to start with an under 2. Because we need to split the set of parallel chords that we created. So go under 2, then over under, over under, and over under. We're going to do the same sequence one more time. Starting with an under 2, which again splits a pair. Then go over under. Over under. And over under. We start our next sequence with an under 2 as well. Then continue with an over 2 to split another pair, then go under over, under over, and under. We start our sequence the same way. Going under 2, then over 2 to split another pair, then under over, under over, and under. We now have 3 sets of parallel chords to split, so we're going to go under 2, then over 2, and under 2. We then continue over under, and over under. We start our next sequence the same way. So under 2, over 2, under 2, then over under, and over under. We're going to continue splitting pairs, going under 2, then over 2, under 2, and over 2. Then go under, over, under. And repeat the same sequence again, starting with an under 2, then over 2, under 2, and over 2, then under, over, under. And we have even more pairs to split now. So we're going to start with an under 2, then go over 2, under 2, over 2 and under 2, and finally over under. We continue the same way, so under 2, over 2, under 2, over 2, under 2, and finally over, under. We start a new sequence by going under 2, over 2, under 2, then over 2, under 2, then over 2 and under 1. We repeat the same sequence, starting with an under 2, then go over 2, under 2, over 2, under 2, and finally over 2, under 1. And we're now at our final pass, which will complete our knot. And it again starts with an under 2, then go over 2, under 2, over 2, under 2, then over 2, and under 1. We're not only going to go under 1 though, but we're going to go on top of the chord that we started it with, on top of the standing end, under 2, and this completes our interweave. The next step is moving our working and standing ends to the center of the knot so we can work on them later. So we're going to follow our standing end with our working end and basically find about the middle point of our knot and then place our working end there. So let's say that this would be about the middle of our knot, and we can now remove our standing end, and we still keep the same sequence of overs and unders, but we have moved our ends into the middle of the knot. We're going to do the same using the other two ends, so with your working end, follow your standing end, and then remove your standing end. And with this, we have placed our ends into the center of the knot, and we can continue with our tutorial. We're now going to take a golf ball, and we're going to tighten our knot around it. If you have any markings on your golf balls, make sure that you don't have them showing on the outside after you have tightened the knot. When you're tightening your knot, you will want to work your slack out of the ends that are sticking at the center of the knot, and it is a good idea that you keep one of the cords a bit longer than the other. I have tightened my knot now, and I have my cords sticking out, and it's time to add a transition knot of some sort. I'm going to do a Matthew Walker knot here, but you could also do a multi-strand star knot, for example. So as you can see, I have arranged my cords, and now I'm going to wrap around with my first cord. And come into the loop that I created at the start. I'm going to take my second cord, go through this loop as well. Come over the front and into the loop that I just made now. I'm going to take my third cord. Come through the first two loops, basically at the center of the knot. Then over the front and into the loop I just made. And we have one more cord. Again, come through all of the loops, basically coming in through the center of the knot. And then back into the loop. Now, Matthew Walker knots, such as this one, are a bit hard to tighten. So you need to do it slowly and with attention so that your cords don't slip out of their lanes. So the tightening process on this knot is the most important part. We're now going to need to move a few cords. So take your bottom one and place it next to the top one. And then the next one, we do the same. And with this, our Matthew Walker knot should be complete. And then we do a bit more tightening. And then we move on to the next part. So we're now going to make the loop, which is made by using a simple 4-strand round braid. So we take our cords and we line them up so that the two cords of one color are on one side and the other two cords on the other. We're now going to start with our top right cord. Go through the cords on the left and back to the right side. Then with our left, we go through the cords on the right and back to the left side. Then right, through the cords on the left, and back to the right side. Then with the left, through the cords on the right, and back to the left side. And we're going to keep doing this until we get a sufficient length for our loop, which you're going to need to guess at first, at least a little bit, but I think about half a foot or so should be more than enough. We have now reached a sufficient length for our top loop, and we're going to join our braid by basically splicing in a couple of ends just to secure them. You could finish this braid using a crown knot to secure it a bit, but it is not absolutely needed. So as you can see, I'm basically working two of the cords into the braid at the bottom in order to secure it. You don't have to be terribly accurate here, because we're going to cover this end with another decorative knot. So with this done, we now need to make a knot to cover our loop, and if desired, you can add a rope thimble into the center of your loop. You can then wrap around here using some sinew or just place your decorative knot on top of it. We're now going to create a final knot that is going to cover the braided sections that we just joined together. We're going to create a simple gaucho fan knot by first placing a little mandrel over your braided loop. This is only to make things a bit easier to see. And we're going to start with one color of cord, wrap it around two times, then go over under, then come around, go over, and under, we're now going to turn back into the knot, starting with an under, then going over two, and finally under one. We're then going to turn back into the knot and split the parallel cords that we just created. So we're going to start with an under, then go over two, and under one. We're now going to split another set of parallel cords by going over under, over under, and over under. We place our working end next to the standing end, and this completes our base knot. We're going to do a gaucho fan knot interweave onto this one, using the other color of cord. We're going to start by following our standing end, and exiting with an over. We're going to re-enter with an under, So under, over, then under one, over two, then under, over, and under two. Since we went under two on the left side, we're going to continue with an over. So we're going to start with an over one, then under one, then go over two to split a pair, then under one, over one, under two, and over one. We're going to re-enter with an under, so under, then over, and under two to split a pair, and over two. We then go under one, over two, and under two. We start with an over one again, going over under, under two that is, to split another pair, then over two, under one, over two, under two, and over one. Then we start with an under one, go over two, under two, over two, under two, and over two, under two. We now place our working end next to the standing end of the same color, and this will complete our gaucho fan knot. The last step you need to do is to now remove that mandrel and now tighten your knot and also place a rope thimble if you have not done so before. We need to also do something with these cords that are sticking out of the knot and out of the braid, and the easiest way to get rid of them is to run them under and through the knot we just created. And we do this with all of the cords. We're then going to simply snip them and tighten our knot around it. So guys, with this, you should have a nice looking golf knot paracord key fob. And if you have any questions about making this item, please let me know in the comments below. Experiment with colors, different knots, and enjoy your work. Thank you and see you next time.